In this video, I'll show you how to fade in and fade out audio in Camtasia using two simple methods. Welcome to this video. My name is David, and if this is your first time watching my videos and you get value from the content that you watch, kindly consider liking this video and sharing it with your friends so that we can all learn together. So this is just a sample video. The videos have been downloaded from pexels.com and the audio is from the YouTube audio library. Let's say this is what we have. I have my narration somewhere here, and you want to fade in and fade out audio. So the first method is using the inbuilt audio effects in Camtasia. And when you select the audio that you want to add the effects to, you can just come to the More tab if you cannot see the audio effects here, and just click on the audio effects. And from this particular section, you can just drag and drop your effect, and it's going to add some points here, and you'll see a slanting line that fades in this particular audio, and you can still drag and drop it to the end to fade out this particular audio. That's a good way to do this. We can also do that for the music and then fade out. Let's just fill it in and then just fade out this particular section as well. Now, that's the first method. It's quick and easy. Let's say we wanted to fade out this particular audio. Let's just scroll back here. When we look at the audio for the music, it might be a little bit high for the narration, so you might need to bring it a little bit lower. So an easy way to do that is by adding audio points. You can easily add audio points when you see these particular sections. When you right click on a particular section where you want to add an audio point, let's say this particular section, then you can click on add audio point, and then you can select a different section where you want to add an audio point, let's say here. Now, the one thing that you need to understand is that an audio point, when you add an audio point to any section, then these particular sections between the audio point are the sections that you can manipulate. So we can easily pull this down and you'll see that it goes up to the end. But if we added another audio point here, then that limits the sections that we can do. For example, we can just scroll down or bring down this particular section without affecting the section to the other end because of this audio point is limiting. You can also see that this particular section is affected, and if we press on Control Z and add another audio point just before this one, we can just manipulate the section in between here. So if you wanted to use this particular fade in and fade out, you can use the audio effects. But if you wanted to fade in and fade out using audio points, you can easily do that, especially for sections where we have narration going on, but you still want your audio to still be audible to the person that is watching. For example, if we play this.
In a video in Camtasia. So, when was the last time you took a vacation? Have you missed seeing the waves crash into the rocks?
So, you can also use the same audio points to adjust the point, the audio above. So let's say, for example, if we move that, you'll notice that even the sections that were faded in and out go up. So let's press on Control Z, and let's say we add an audio point somewhere before this, and then another one somewhere here, so that we just manipulate what is between these two audio points and nothing else. So we can just move that up. So you'll just see this section between these audio points move, and we can just listen to it now.
When was the last time you took a vacation?
So really depends on what you're looking for and the desired effect. So that's how you can easily add fade in and fade outs to a video or audio in a video in Camtasia. Thanks for watching. Until next time, stay safe. My name is David. Thanks for watching.